Underground mining. Underground mining is a method of extracting valuable minerals or ores that are buried deep within the Earth's crust. This technique involves excavating tunnels and shafts to access the mineral deposits, which are often unreachable through surface mining methods due to overlying rock, soil, or other obstacles. It's a complex process that requires careful planning, specialized equipment, and adherence to strict safety protocols. The process typically begins with exploration to identify potential mineral deposits. Once a promising site is located, engineers and geologists assess its feasibility and determine the best approach for extraction. This may involve drilling core samples, conducting geological surveys, and analyzing the composition of the ore body. Once the decision is made to proceed with underground mining, the first step is to create access to the deposit. This is usually achieved by sinking vertical shafts or excavating inclined tunnels, known as adits, into the earth. These openings provide entry points for miners and equipment and allow for the transportation of extracted materials to the surface. Once access is established, the actual mining process begins. Depending on the nature of the deposit and the mining method chosen, various techniques may be employed. Common underground mining methods include room and pillar mining. This method involves the excavation of rooms, open areas, separated by pillars of ore or rock to support the overlying strata. Miners extract the ore from the rooms while leaving the pillars intact to prevent collapse. Longwall mining. In this technique, a longwall machine is used to extract a continuous panel of coal or ore along the length of a seam. As the machine advances, hydraulic supports are installed to prevent roof collapse. Cut and fill mining. This method is used in irregular ore deposits where the ore body is narrow or steeply dipping. Miners excavate the ore in horizontal slices, or cuts, and then backfill the mined out areas with waste material to provide support. Sublevel stoping. In sublevel stoping, ore is extracted from a series of horizontal sublevels created within the ore body. Drilling and blasting are used to break up the ore, which is then loaded and transported to the surface via haulage equipment. Block caving. This is a large-scale mining method used for low-grade, massive ore bodies. In block caving, the ore body is undermined, causing it to collapse under its weight. The broken ore is then extracted from draw points located beneath the caved-in area. Throughout the mining process, safety is of paramount importance. Underground mines can be hazardous environments due to the risk of cave-ins, gas leaks, fires, and other accidents. Miners must undergo extensive training and follow strict safety protocols to minimize the risk of injury or death. Once the ore has been extracted, it is transported to the surface for processing and refining. This may involve crushing, grinding, and separating the valuable minerals from the surrounding rock. The final product is then shipped to smelters or refineries for further processing or use in manufacturing. Overall, underground mining is a challenging but essential method for accessing valuable mineral resources that are hidden beneath the Earth's surface. Despite the technical and safety challenges involved, advances in technology and safety practices continue to make underground mining more efficient and sustainable. How is underground mining done? Underground mining is a complex process that involves several steps and techniques to extract valuable minerals or ores buried deep beneath the Earth's surface. Here's a detailed explanation of how underground mining is typically done. Exploration and site selection. The process begins with geological surveys and exploration to identify potential mineral deposits. Geologists study the composition of the Earth's crust, analyze rock samples, and use various techniques such as remote sensing and drilling to locate ore bodies. Once a promising site is identified, detailed assessments are conducted to determine its economic viability and feasibility for underground mining. Access development. Once a site is selected for underground mining, the first step is to create access to the mineral deposit. This typically involves sinking vertical shafts or excavating inclined tunnels, known as adits, into the earth. Shaft sinking requires specialized equipment and techniques to safely penetrate the ground and provide access for miners, equipment, and materials. Adits are horizontal tunnels driven into the side of a hill or mountain to reach the ore body. Infrastructure construction. After access is established, infrastructure such as ventilation systems, electrical installations, and water management facilities must be constructed to support mining operations. Ventilation is crucial to ensure a constant supply of fresh air for miners and to remove harmful gases such as methane and carbon monoxide. Electrical systems power equipment and lighting underground, while water management systems control groundwater and prevent flooding in the mine. Mining operations. With access and infrastructure in place, mining operations can commence. The choice of mining method depends on factors such as the geometry and characteristics of the ore body, as well as economic and safety considerations. Common underground mining methods include room and pillar mining, longwall mining, cut and fill mining, sublevel stoping, and block caving. Extraction of ore. In room and pillar mining, miners excavate rooms, open areas, separated by pillars of ore or rock. The ore is extracted using drilling, blasting, and loading equipment, while leaving the pillars intact to support the overlying strata. In longwall mining, a continuous panel of coal or ore is extracted along the length of a seam using specialized longwall machines and hydraulic supports. Transportation and haulage. Once the ore is extracted, it must be transported to the surface for processing. This is typically done using conveyors, rail systems, or hoists, depending on the depth and configuration of the mine. Haulage equipment such as trucks or railcars may be used to transport the ore to the surface or to underground processing facilities. Processing and refining. At the surface, the extracted ore undergoes processing and refining to separate the valuable minerals from the surrounding rock. This may involve crushing, grinding, flotation, and other beneficiation techniques to concentrate the desired minerals into a marketable product. Further refining processes may be required to produce pure metals or high-grade mineral concentrates. Reclamation and closure. Finally, once mining operations have ceased, the mine site must be reclaimed and restored to minimize environmental impacts and ensure long-term stability. This may involve backfilling mined-out areas, stabilizing slopes, restoring vegetation, and implementing long-term monitoring and maintenance programs. Closure plans must also address issues such as water management, waste disposal, and community engagement to ensure a smooth transition from active mining to post-mining land use. Overall, underground mining is a complex and challenging process that requires careful planning, skilled labor, and adherence to strict safety and environmental standards. Advances in technology and mining practices continue to improve efficiency, safety, and sustainability in underground mining operations. Underground mining methods. Underground mining methods encompass a variety of techniques used to extract valuable minerals or ores from beneath the earth's surface. These methods vary in complexity, cost, and suitability depending on factors such as the type of ore deposit, its depth, geometry, and surrounding geological conditions. Here are some common underground mining methods, each with its own advantages and applications. Room and pillar mining. This method is well suited for flat or gently dipping or deposits with thick seams. It involves the excavation of rooms, open areas, separated by pillars of ore or rock to support the overlying strata. Miners extract the ore from the rooms using machinery, while leaving the pillars intact to prevent collapse. Room and pillar mining is commonly used in coal mining and certain metallic ore deposits. Longwall mining. Longwall mining is a highly mechanized method used for extracting coal or large, continuous ore bodies with uniform geology. In this method, a longwall shearer machine is used to cut a long, continuous panel of coal or ore along the length of the seam. Hydraulic roof supports are installed to control roof collapse as the machine advances. Longwall mining allows for high production rates and efficient extraction of resources but requires substantial initial investment in equipment and infrastructure. Cut and fill mining. Cut-and-fill mining is used in irregular ore deposits where the ore body is narrow, steeply dipping, or discontinuous. In this method, miners excavate the ore in horizontal slices, or cuts, and then backfill the mined-out areas with waste material to provide support. Cut-and-fill mining is particularly suited for narrow vein deposits and areas with complex geological structures. Sublevel stoping. Sublevel stoping is a versatile mining method used for medium to large ore bodies with steep dip angles. In this method, ore is extracted from a series of horizontal sublevels created within the ore body. Miners drill and blast the ore, which is then loaded and transported to the surface via haulage equipment. Sublevel stoping allows for selective mining of ore zones and efficient extraction of resources from deep underground. Block caving. Block caving is a large-scale mining method used for low-grade, massive ore bodies with extensive vertical and horizontal extents. In this method, the ore body is undermined, causing it to collapse under its weight. The broken ore is then extracted from draw points located beneath the caved-in area. Block caving is highly productive and cost-effective but requires careful engineering and monitoring to control ground subsidence and maintain safety. Sublevel caving. Sublevel caving is a variation of block caving suited for ore bodies with moderate to steep dip angles. In this method, the ore body is undercut by a series of horizontal sublevels, and the broken ore is allowed to collapse into draw points located at the bottom of the cave. Sublevel caving offers advantages in terms of ore recovery and cost efficiency but requires careful planning to control cave propagation and minimize dilution. Drift and fill mining. Drift and fill mining is similar to cut and fill mining but involves the use of horizontal drifts or tunnels to access the ore body. Miners excavate the ore in horizontal slices and then backfill the mined-out areas with waste material. Drift and fill mining is suitable for narrow vein deposits and areas with limited access. Room and pillar with retreat mining. This method combines room and pillar mining with retreat mining, allowing for the extraction of additional ore from previously mined-out areas. Miners progressively remove the pillars, allowing the roof to collapse and the remaining ore to be extracted. Room and pillar with retreat mining is used in coal mining and certain metallic ore deposits. These are just a few examples of the underground mining methods employed in the mining industry. Each method has its advantages and limitations, and the choice of method depends on factors such as ore deposit characteristics, geological conditions, mining economics, and environmental considerations. Advances in technology and mining practices continue to improve the efficiency, safety, and sustainability of underground mining operations.